We got this poster from 1932 advertising the Chevrolet Coupe. This poster needed a lot of restoration. There was paper missing, there was stains, and it needed a lot of touch-up. And I'm going to show this to you. But before I show you that, I have to show you this. We're preparing a screen, and I am putting water on the paper to begin its absorption. Then I will apply this wheat paste. The paper is already partially absorbed, it's expanding, and the wheat paste is helping to stretch it out. I have to try to make sure the bigger air pockets are taken out of the poster. I'm applying more water with the squeegee and in effect pushing out more of the air pockets with this. And now by rolling the poster, I am able to get rid of all remaining air pockets and make sure that the paper is nice and snug.
Another bump.
And now Jinbei is going to do the honors of linen backing this poster.
Chevrolet.
It'll be the first poster we put on this screen today.
It's got some staining on it, but it's too fragile to bleach. So I'm going to touch it up cosmetically.
Enough water?
Yes. Doesn't need a big border.
No, I was meant to push.
Oh, okay.
So we have the two biggest posters.
Here you go. That'll fit on there. Is it possible? I suppose it is. Congratulations.
That was like, if it's anything fragile, I'll just work safe and do this. Yeah, for the four other posters, I'll just put the wheat paste on the paper. That isn't a problem.
The 1920s was the decade of the automobile in America. The automobile industry accounted for a great deal of the gross domestic product, the gross national product. The booming stock market owed a lot to Detroit, which was a booming city, the Motor City, where most of the cars used in the world were made in Detroit. Today, Detroit's population is less than half of what it was then. Still, the average American family could only afford one car because inflation was so high. Still, you could get easy credit in the 1920s. These are facts. Chevrolet was the most popular car. It was designed for the middle class. It was considered practical and fulfilled most of the needs and desires of the modern age.
Flirting with a woman.
That's right. Sex sells. Flirting with a woman. And look at her. She's sitting behind the wheel of a car. This is the 1920s, the flapper age, the age where women started to vote. Just like with bicycle ads that represent women being liberated from the home. She's saying to the guy, "You want to come up to my place?"
In a few days, the Chevrolet Motor Company will announce a great new car. We believe it is unquestionably the finest motor car this company has ever designed or built. Chevrolet's success has been due largely to the loyalty of its owners. Therefore, we are giving you this advance information so that you can arrange to be one of the first to experience the thrills of driving this new car. And when we say thrills, we mean just that. You will get the thrill of a smooth 60 horsepower six-cylinder engine with a speed of 65 to 70 miles per hour. The thrill of driving the first and only low-priced car with both simplified preheating and the silent shift synchromate transmission. You will get the thrill of ultra-modern styling in smart new body tri-fishing. And finally, the thrill of Chevrolet's greater comfort, durability, and economy at prices among the lowest at which motor cars are sold. So take advantage of this advanced information to Chevrolet owners. And whether or not you intend to buy, arrange to drive this new car yourself and learn firsthand why Chevrolet is truly the great American value for 1932.
The screen, she is finished. And that looks so good.
Le fini.
Let us put this in the hall to dry. And now we're going to restore this poster. Oki is now going to do the touch-up, but first she'll be putting in paper pulp. Paper pulp is what we use to fill in the missing areas of paper. It is a mixture of paper powder and archival glue. This will be sanded and then touched up with archival water reversible color. Thank you. You can put it on here.
Well, we have to finish first this one, right?
Yeah, you don't have to. You can put it pure from there onto here without touching it up. That color will match this without any.
I don't think so.
But it's close enough. You have to paint the whole border anyway.
I know. But I have to match it here. Dark.
Oh, maybe. So you can put some white with it.
This is Chevrolet, right?
Yeah, Chevrolet.
Now Korean make Chevy.
Korea, yeah. Chevrolet was...
Daewoo makes Chevy.
Daewoo makes Chevy. Chevrolet was the most popular GM car in the 20th century, starting in the 1920s. It was a car designed for the middle class.
I'm gonna touch it onto up here, not here.
Okay.
But it's hard to match it. I cannot paint more of it. You know?
Yeah, you don't have to paint all of that.
I'm gonna touch up here, and then I'm gonna pencil work here.
Okay, you can touch up this, like
yeah.
one time. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Stop the touch up there, and then just blend it with pencil. Looking for another color to bring out something else.
You want me to paint here or not?
Yeah, paint there. Paint those spots out.
Really?
Yep.
Running low on colors?
Yeah, the color we already use.
Looks good.
Well, there you have it. A 1932 original poster advertising the Chevrolet Coupe. Conservation linen-backed and restored by Poster Fix, where we bring your posters back to life.